Welcome to Channel Today in History. In today's video, we will talk about the day September 29, 1957. Kishtim Disaster. The Kishtim Disaster was a radioactive contamination accident that occurred on September 29, 1957 at Mayak, a nuclear weapons plutonium production site and nuclear fuel reprocessing plant in the Soviet Union. It is measured as a level 6 disaster on the international scale of nuclear events, I.N.E.S. making it the third most serious nuclear accident in history, behind the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear disaster and the Chernobyl disaster, level 7 in the I.N.E.S. The event took place in the city of Oziorsk, Chelyabinsk Oblast, a closed city built around the Mayak factory. Since Oziorsk/Mayak, also known as Chelyabinsk 40 and Chelyabinsk 65, was not marked on maps, the disaster was named after Kishtim, the closest known to the city. Oziorsk today. After World War II, the Soviet Union lagged behind the US in developing nuclear weapons, so it began a rapid research and development program to produce sufficient amounts of uranium and plutonium. The Mayak factory was built in haste between 1945 and 1948. Gaps in Soviet physicists' knowledge of nuclear physics at the time, it is difficult to judge the safety of many decisions. Environmental concerns were not taken seriously during the early development phase. All six reactors were located on the shores of Lake Kizilhash and used an open-cycle refrigeration system, discharging contaminated water directly back into the lake. Initially, Mayak was dumping highly radioactive waste into a nearby river, which was carrying the waste into the Obi River, flowing further down to the Arctic Ocean. Later, Lake Karakay was used for outdoor storage. A liquid nuclear waste storage facility was added around 1953. It consisted of steel tanks mounted on a concrete base, 8.2 meters deep. Because of the high level of radiation, the garbage was heating up through heat decay, although a chain reaction was not possible. For this reason, a cooler was built around each bank, containing 20 tanks. Facilities to monitor the operation of coolers and tank contents were inadequate. Explosion. In 1956, the cooling system in one of the tanks containing about 70 to 80 tons of liquid radioactive waste failed and was not repaired. The temperature began to rise, resulting in the evaporation and chemical explosion of the dry residues, which mainly consisted of ammonium nitrate and acetates, see ammonium nitrate/pump fuel oil. The explosion on September 29, 1957, estimated to have a force of about 70 to 100 tons of TNT, through the 160-ton concrete cap into the air. There were no immediate casualties as a result of the explosion, but it released an estimate of 20 MCI, 800 PBQ, of radioactivity. Most of this contamination settled near the crash site and contributed to the Teka River's pollution, but a plume containing 2 MCI, 80 PBQ, of radionuclides spread over hundreds of kilometers. Previously contaminated areas within the affected area include the Teka River, which ended up receiving 2.75 MCI, 100 PBQ, of deliberately dumped waste, and Lake Karakay, which had received 120 MCI, 4,000 PBQ. Within 10 to 11 hours, the radioactive cloud moved northeast, reaching 300 to 350 kilometers from the accident. The cloud precipitation resulted in a long-term contamination of an area of more than 800 to 20,000 square kilometers. Depending on the level of contamination, it is considered significant, mainly with cesium-137 and strontium-90. This area is generally referred to as the eastern traces of the radioactive Urals, EURT. Evacuations. At least 22 villages were exposed to the disaster's radiation, with a total population of around 10,000 people who were evacuated. Some evacuated after a week, but it took almost 2 years to evacuate elsewhere. Did you like the video? In the description, you will find the blog link with the full article. Give an incentive by subscribing to the channel, liking, commenting, and sharing with your friends. Hugs. Until the next.